Hi folks, hope you're okay today. It's good to be with you. I just want to share with you about the value of expository preaching and teaching, and just to share my experience of that recently over the last 18 months. If you turn to 2 Timothy, chapter 4, 2 Timothy chapter 4, it says, I charge thee before God and the Lord Jesus Christ, that shall judge the quick and the dead, as is appearing in his kingdom. Preach the word, be instant, in season, out of season. Rebuke, exhort with all longsuffering and doctrine. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lust shall they heap to themselves teachers having itching ears. So Paul says there, preach the word in season and out of season. And I just want to share with you my experience of expository preaching and expository teaching and the value that it has been in my life and in my ministry. And I hope it inspires you to do the same. And I'm going to talk about preaching and preachers and books about preaching. And I hope that this inspires you to go down a path that I think you're going to find much more rewarding in your ministry as a preacher. So, about 18 months ago, I was asked by some friends of a Reformed Presbyterian background to start to preach for them. So I began to preach. And I began to go through chapter by chapter through midweek on a Thursday through certain books. So we went through James chapter by chapter. We went through Titus chapter by chapter. And then eventually I started to preach on a Sunday chapter by chapter through a book, and we've been going through Romans for a while. And over that 18 month period, it's been a tremendous blessing. First of all, expository preaching means you've got to really study a book. You've got to really study the Word of God and really, really grapple with it, really get your text in the context. So for example, if you're going through the Gospel of John, we went through the Gospel of John chapter by chapter, it means you've got to study the chapter and make sure that the next chapter you go to, you've got it in context. And it requires a lot of hard work in studying the Word of God. You can't just pick your sermons from thin air. You've really got to study the Word of God. So for me, it's been really a tremendous encouragement to me. And I've really grown a lot as a Christian and a servant of the Lord. I've really, really grown a lot by doing this expository teaching and preaching. Because it's disciplined me week by week to really get into the scriptures. Whereas before and in the past in ministry, because you pick an isolated text here and there, you can study that passage, but it doesn't require the same discipline and the same depth of study that doing expository preaching, because you've got to study the book, you've got to study the context a lot more, and it requires a lot more hard work, I think. The other thing as well, but based on my own personal and private life, is all the preparation that I've been doing has been such a blessing. Because, like, for example, let's say I was preaching on John chapter 1. I would listen to about 3 or 4 sermons by other preachers, then I would read lots of commentaries on it and study the passage. By the time I've finished studying, I've got so much material myself and been blessed myself before I give it to others. So that's been a tremendous blessing to me. The sheer intake of the Word of God and imbibing the Word of God has been tremendous. And I feel that I'm slowly growing much more deeper as a Christian because of that discipline. Second thing is as a Christian, just as a Christian and as a servant of the Lord, it helps you to be more balanced. Because as you study the Word of God, you have to get things in context. As you go, say, through chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3 of the Gospel of John, chapter 4, chapter 5, you get everything in its balance, in its context. And that's the beauty of expository preaching. It helps you to get things in balance. It helps you to get doctrine in the right balance. So the issues of sovereignty and responsibility of man, you get it in its perfect balance as you study the scriptures in an expository way. I think also doing expository teaching through midweek Bible study, it helps the congregation to grow a lot better, I think, because they're grasping whole swathes of scripture. They're looking at things in the proper context. They're getting things in their proper balance, because you're allowing scripture to speak every week without you trying to put your own agenda in, and allowing people to discuss and ask questions about the chapter that you're looking at helps them to think through the scripture. But also it helps you because you're able to share the depth of study that you've shared. So it's a two-way win, where you've been able to do the study and you can share your studies, but people can read it and then they can discuss it. And so it helps them to think things through. Midweek expository preaching on a Sunday, has been really helpful, that we've been able to get into the book of Romans in a deeper way than we would normally have, just picking a text here and there. And again, it teaches people balance. You get the right balance of how Scripture presents doctrine. And I think, it's much more deeper, much more edifying, much more balanced way to build a church and to build a people of God. Expository preaching is what's needed in the church today. The church is asleep. For example, there's no righteous indignation anymore. Very few people get angry about abortion. Nobody's really bothered about certain political issues today, like with gay marriage and things like that. Nobody's really concerned about these issues as they should, and the church has become desensitized, and it's taken on the world and imbibed the world's ethos and the world's thinking. And the way to get the world out of the church is to get the word back in the church, and that is by expository preaching. There's a lot of entertainment going on in church. There's a heck of a lot of, especially in America, but there's a lot of undermining sound doctrine in scholars and pastors saying that the Bible is wrong on sexual ethics, that the Bible is just got mistakes in it, that the Bible is not properly the Word of God as we thought, and challenges on the doctrine of hell, challenges on the doctrine of basically, there's so many challenges going on at the moment around the world concerning biblical truth. The best way to fight back is to reinstitute expository preaching, because as you do expository preaching, it will clean out all these issues, and they will get exposed as the truth of the Word of God is preached. There's a heck of a lot of emphasis in preaching today on telling stories, a lot of emphasis on preachers glorifying themselves, a lot of emphasis on feelings. Expository preaching brings a depth, and it's more Christ-centered and God-focused, because it's all scripture. not people telling their stories all the time, or people just preaching on feeling. It is also a killer of dead orthodoxy. Dead orthodoxy quenches the spirit, but when you allow the Spirit of God and the Word of God, expository speaking, to unfold, it kind of warms people's hearts and revives people and refreshes people. And I would say that there's a famine in the land. There's a famine of the Word of God. There's a famine and a dearth of good expository preachers and Bible teachers, and we need more of them. And so my challenge to you today is, what are you going to do? Are you going to go on the same way as you've been doing? Or are you going to pray and say, Lord, I want to expound your word. Teach me how to do it. And in your Bible study, pray for a book to go through. And go through it chapter by chapter. And then on a Sunday, pray for the Lord to say, Lord, what do you want me to preach on? Do you want me to do some expository preaching? And pick a book and go through it chapter by chapter. Sometimes it doesn't have to be a chapter. You can go through it. I've done Romans and I've done chapter by chapter, and now I've got to about chapter 12, and I'm just camping on two or three verses there, where normally I've done full chapter, but I've just camped on a few verses here and there, and maybe I'll start again on a whole chapter. But so you don't have to do a whole chapter, but you're just going systematically through the book. Why don't you try it? Give it a go. Pray about it. Give it a go. Search the scriptures. See what the scriptures teach about it. But I guarantee that it will be such a blessing to you when you start doing expository preaching and teaching. It will be a massive, massive change in your ministry. It will be a massive change in you as a leader. You'll see a seismic change in your attitude, in your thinking. You will just change beyond all recognition when you start doing expository preaching. It will revolutionize your personal life. It will revolutionize your ministry. And it will just revolutionize your church. Your church will be transformed. And it will revolutionize, because it will be Christ exalting. It will be Spirit-filled, and it will be powerful, and it will be such a blessing that people will just be wanting to get more and more of it as time goes on, because they're drinking in the truths of the Word of God. So that's what I think. I think that's the value of expository preaching, and I would just really encourage you to do that. Calvin did it. He did expository preaching. Many of the great saints in the past, many of the Puritans, many of the great preachers did expository preaching. Dr. Martin Lloyd-Jones. So those are my thoughts. I hope that inspires you. I hope that encourages you. If you want to get inspired as a preacher, there's a new documentary come out called Logic on Fire. It's about the life of Dr. Martin Lloyd-Jones, and I would really encourage you to go and get the DVD and watch it, and to encourage your preachers to watch it. And it will really inspire you to your preaching and inspire your church as well. So hope that's been a blessing to you. A really good book on expository preaching. I would have it with two books that I would have on preaching. Well, there's a couple. So I think one is Expository Preaching by John MacArthur. That's an excellent book on the tools for expository preaching. It's by, I think, the Master Seminary lecturers. And it is an absolute excellent book. It really is an excellent book on expository preaching. It's a classic, and it will give you all the basic tools to begin to work on being an expositor in preaching. But I'd say that you need that book, and then there's a book by John Piper on preaching, think it's The Glory of God in Preaching. I would have that alongside the John MacArthur book, because the Piper one is there's quite a bit about the importance of the Holy Spirit in that book. So those are two excellent books that I would encourage you to read, to encourage you to do preaching and expository preaching. And then there's some books by Stuart Olliott, published by, I think, the Banner of Truth. So if you look at the Banner of Truth, there's two books by the Banner of Truth on preaching by Stuart Olliott. They're very helpful in practical advice on the physicalities of preaching. Okay. I hope that's been a blessing, and I hope that encourages you. I hope to hear that many of you who hear this video start expository preaching and teaching in your churches. And the church is going to be truly blessed when you do that. God bless you.